So it's going to be three-time Super Bowl champ Devin McCourty of the New England Patriots joining us from Alpine, New Jersey. Devin, we appreciate the time, man.
No, I appreciate you having me on.
All right. I want to get deep into the Patriots secrets here.
We got to.
As a Jets fan, and maybe someday, somehow, you can overcome what's going on up there in New England. I mean, you are a local guy, but we got more important things to get to first.
Yeah, I want to get to it, too, because this is going to be year number 9 that you've been with the Patriots since they drafted you back in 2010. But let's start things off with this football camp that you and your identical twin brother, Jason, have been putting on for the past 8 years. It's up in Nyack, New York. And you guys always make sure that no matter how busy the schedules are, that you're taking time out to help teach the youth through a couple of days of just instructional camps. No hitting, just all instruction.
Yeah, man, we've been doing it. You know, I think the biggest thing for us, we always want to get back to where we were from. A lot of people, you know, believed in us and gave us a lot as we were growing up, and it was a big part of our foundation. So we go back there about 3-4 hours. We're in front of kids. We're teaching them football, giving them pizza. It was just a good time. We race all the kids by age group. 8 years strong. We haven't lost a race. So it's a lot of fun just to be able to do all of that stuff.
And to be able to work with your brother, obviously with the kids, with this camp is one thing. To win a Super Bowl with them, though, and I know you've talked about this a lot, but I'm sure you probably don't get tired of it. What, you know, you've won Super Bowls before, but to have him by your side, what did that mean?
That was awesome, you know, and especially everything he's been through as far as playing football, to play 10 years, and that'd be the first time he reached the playoffs, and to do it the right way, reach the playoffs and then make it all the way through and win it. You know, it was an unbelievable feeling. Just that last field goal that it was missed by the Rams, we just jumped and started hugging each other, yelling and screaming. We both dreamed about playing in the NFL, never dreamed of playing together, really never dreamed of winning a Super Bowl together. So to be able to do that in the first year, you know, I don't know if we'll ever be able to top that.
Yeah, an outstanding accomplishment. I know you guys had your moments, the emotions coming out, but you had family there as well, right? We saw the nice picture with you guys, with your mom, and understanding of what that meant to her. Did she kind of relay any messages to you guys, or was it just more so speaking through tears and emotions?
Yeah, she just soaked it all in, I think. You know, seeing her on the field, she laid out. She was doing angels in the confetti. she did interviews at the team hotel. I think it was a Thursday or Friday before the game. So she was just really enjoying all of the moments, and you know, to be out there on the field, her, our wives, our 5 kids combined, just on the field having a blast, really is what it's about, and I think that's what we probably enjoyed the most.
Not everybody can play for Bill Belichick, but you obviously have had great success with him to a point where he's also thrown, which he rarely does, compliments your way about how he couldn't be prouder to coach a player like you. What is it like to play for Bill Belichick?
It's great. You know, I think, you know, it's a lot of, you know, I would say rumors or like this huge mystique of playing for him. But really it comes down to just being able to do what you're asked to do out there. And as you build trust, I think coach lets you do more and more things. And you've seen guys come in there maybe as a rookie or a free agent signing and they have success right away because they give you a lot of opportunities in New England to do what you do best. And, you know, for me, this will be my 10th year there in New England. And I've been able to do that each year, you know, carve out a niche that I do well in, just listen to the coaching. You know, we have some of the best coaches, obviously Coach Belichick, probably the greatest coach of all time. If you just listen to him, you'll be able to find some success on that football field.
So then what happens for the players who can't handle it? Like, what is the difference? So obviously it's perfect for you. Obviously it fits you to a T, that type of coaching or that type of system. But when there's players who can't, like, what do you notice? Do you notice it right away, too? Do you say, oh, this guy's not going to last?
Oh, yeah, there's times. But I think that happens on every team. You know, I think you kind of learn, you know, in the NFL, there's 32 teams, and it's really 32 different ways. Everybody does it different. And sometimes we get guys in there, and I can tell week one just from their reaction, what they're used to, as they start explaining what they're used to, that I'm like, I don't know if this is going to work out for them. And I think that's the beauty of the NFL. You know, if it doesn't work out with us, there's still 31 other teams you can kind of jump on and try to have success with. But there's a very particular way that things need to be done in New England. And you've seen through the years, if you can't do it that way, they get rid of you and they try to find someone else. And, you know, that's the business of the NFL.
Well, Devin, I know you heard the old saying, iron sharpens iron, right? So you go up against one of the greatest, if not the greatest, quarterback in NFL football history in Tom Brady. So practicing against him every single day, what's that like? And when you go out on Sundays, is it like, okay, well, I saw Tom and was going against him all week. What you're going to throw at me is really going to be cakewalk.
Yeah, it's fun because exactly what you're saying is what happens. He came in there at a three-day mini camp, and anybody that knows Tom, you know, people are like, oh, he wasn't OTA. This guy comes in, and you could tell he's already watched all of the OTA film, ready to go, knows what's been going on. And he talked trash as soon as he came in about different plays that had happened and was like, don't worry about it, that's over. These next 3 days is going to be totally different for the defense. And we enjoy that. You know, it's very competitive offense, defense, all throughout, you know, the OTAs, mini camp. Now we'll go into training camp in a week. And we'll just go at each other. And I think being able to go at a guy that caliber makes you better. And I think you see that in our defense each year as we just continue to get better and better throughout the season. Comes from him and really from that whole quarterback room that he always has a trickle-down effect on.
Now, I told you we had to talk about the Jets, so I have to real quick ask you what you think, because I need to know from inside the Patriots, when you're looking outward towards the Jets, How do you view this team? Do you guys look at it as just, you know, nothing? This is not interested. We go down there and we just spank that team. What is the real view from Patriots towards the Jets?
It's always going to be one of our toughest games. You know, you talk about all three of the teams in our division, New York, Miami, and Buffalo. We've been down there. We've lost in overtime. We've come down there and win on the last, you know, defensive play. I remember 2 years ago, Chris Long gets a strip sack to end the game as they're driving down the field to try to win. So each time we play down there, you know, Jenkins fumble, not fumble in the end zone where everyone was mad at. It's never easy game. You know, the Jets know us well, and then now you add Adam Gase, who was in Miami, so he knows us well. And, you know, we lost plenty of games in Miami going down there. So it's always tough trying to play a team like that because I think – of the familiarity of, you know, just trying to do things. They know it. We know it. So it's always a battle when we go down there and play.
Now, Devin, not only were you guys the first set of twins to win in a Super Bowl together, but I think they might have been the first twins to give a commencement speech. You guys were back at your alma mater at Rutgers University. Both graduates there, 09. Jason got his degree, you in 2010. This past spring, you guys were able to speak to those graduates of that class. How did you work out the speech? That's what I want to know.
It took a long time. You know, you talk about, like, playing for Coach Belichick. Our wives were by far way harder on us trying to do that speech than Coach Belichick was. But it was tough, man. We stayed up a couple nights till the early morning of trying to figure out how to get that done. And good thing for all the graduating students, the best time we did it was that day. You know, if they would have had to hear any of the practice runs, they would have been highly disappointed in what we came with.
For more great videos from the MSG 150, check out right there. And remember, our show is on Monday through Thursday, 8 to 10:30 p.m. on MSG Network and MSG Go.